Okay, in previous video we have seen a cross fly bias angle construction. We have seen in this case the plies are placed one over the other and the directions are opposite to each other. Okay, that's why it is called as cross ply bias angle construction. After that we have seen bias belted construction. Apart from that opposite plies, one more additional stabilizer belt is used in this construction, we have seen. And advantages we have seen due to this, it is happened that they have greater road mileage, it has run coolers as compared to a cross ply, and it has improved traction effect. Okay, all these things are good as compared to cross ply when we are using bias belt construction. Okay, only thing we have used additional belt. Okay, now we will see one more tire type, that is radial ply construction. Okay, this is the third type of tire. First we have seen cross ply, second we have seen bias belt construction, and third is radial ply construction. Okay, here the plies are placed one over the other. Here is the bead you are observing here, and all plies are meet at the center. Okay, one ply over other. Okay, and this type of arrangement is called as radial ply construction. Okay, and apart from that we are using a stabilizer belts. Only thing is, in previous belts we are using a plies one over other in different direction, but here they are radial. Okay, there one end is at a bead here, second end is here, and they have constructed in this way. That's why the arrangement is a radial ply construction arrangement. Okay, just we will see in detail. These radial ply construction tires have plies running from bead to bead across the crown at right angles to the rotation. Okay, right angles to the rotation, from bead to bead across the crown at right angle to the rotation. And next is the side walls, the direction of these plies is radial, hence the name is given it as a radial ply construction. Okay, and the tread angle, the chord angle varies between 18 to 22 degree. Okay, here in case previously we have seen that angle as a 40 degree to 45 degree, but in this case this angle is 18 to 22 degree. Okay, and the number of layers, it depends on which material you are using. Either you are using nylon or RB, PB, what type of materials, synthetic rubber or natural rubber, and which additives we are using, it depends on that, as well as lateral stiffness needed. The lower tire is required to carry in the weight of the vehicle and the weight of the passenger. All these things we have to decide before you are going to number of layers which you are going to use. And what is the advantages of that radial ply construction? The main advantage is it reduces cornering wear, it increases overall life of the tire, and the radial plies gives greater pliability and comfort. Okay, greater pliability means you should able to place one ply over other, and it will become a good unit. Okay, as compared to previous ones. And what is the disadvantage? There is no directional stability, okay, which comes from breakers, as well as it firmly restricts any lateral stretching of the thread, and it slightly harder ride at low speed. Okay, slightly harder ride at low speed, and it is expensive as compared to previous two types of tires. Okay, tire construction. Once again, we will see the main difference is the ply starts from one bead to other bead. Okay, and the direction is perpendicular to the rotation. This type is the direction of rotation, and it is perpendicular to the direction of rotation. Okay, and here the pliability is more as compared to previous two sections. Okay, and these are slight expensive. Okay, now we will see the different types of tread pattern, because our road or the tire require better grip to provide stability to the vehicle. There should be a different types of tread patterns are there. They are also provide cushioning effect from the vibrations on the uneven road surface, and to fulfilling these requirements, tread pattern plays important role. Okay, just again I will repeat. First, the tire tread pattern play important role, which first the grip of the vehicle or the tire's grip to the road depends on this tread pattern, as well as this grip will provide stability to the automobile, as well as the cushioning effect. Okay, there should be a vibration should be absorbed by when the road is uneven, road surface conditions are there. This will be possible with the help of different types of tread pattern on the tire. There are four types of tread pattern. First is directional tread pattern. Second is non-directional tread pattern. Third is tire with symmetrically designed pattern, and tire with asymmetrically designed pattern. It is means we can say that first is related with direction and second is related with symmetry. Okay, now we will see what is the directional tire. We just here see the figure number one, directional pattern. It is designed to rotate in a particular direction. Okay, wheel is moving in particular direction, and that direction is designated by this directional tread pattern or directional tire, we can say. Especially when the direction is not particular, vehicle is not moving, or the direction of the vehicle is not particular, then it will not work properly, or we can say that it will affect on the performance of the vehicle. Okay, performance of the rotation. Okay, we can say that the rear wheels or tractor, we are having directional treads pattern, or we can say directional tires. Second is non-directional tire. It is made to rotate in any direction. Okay, if you are using the tread pattern on a tire, you can go ahead, you can go backward, you can rotate the right hand, left hand turn, it is possible. Then we can say that this particular tire is or tread pattern is designed to go to any direction. You can rotate it any direction. if you rotate in any direction, the performance will not affect. Okay, so that these are preferred, okay, especially in military vehicles. Okay, and in case of agriculture work, especially for tractors, rear wheel, the direction is directional tire they are using. Okay, and the third is tire with symmetrically designed patterns. Okay, as its name indicate, at the center line of the width, it is symmetrical. Okay, this tire is used. When it is asymmetric, then it is called as asymmetrically designed pattern. But it is having very good use. Okay, asymmetrical tire has a very use. Here a figure is shown. First is they have better grips as compared to directional type of tires when automobile is moving. It also has inside hub pattern help to achieve better grip during motion on straight path. Okay, inside hub portion is a very useful for better grip during a motion. When outside hub pattern is used to achieve the same during the motion on the curved path, means we will going to take advantage of symmetrical or non-direct, symmetrical and asymmetrical, both according to the road path or the surface conditions. It can withstand on both straight path as well as curved path. It is also withstand when the road condition is wet, means there is a rainy season and the water should be removed away from the tire, and the tread patterns or the pattern, tread pattern helps the tire to perform this function. This will not allow the water to come inside or in between that tires, and also this provides stability to the automobile during rainy conditions or rainy weather conditions. Is it clear? This is all about tread pattern. From exam point of view, you should able to define what is directional tread tire, non-directional tire, tire with symmetrically designed pattern, and tire with asymmetrically designed pattern. In asymmetric, half portion is for straight path, half portion is for curved path, and also the pattern is not allowed to flow of the water from away from the tires. By using this weight, it will able to run, or it will able to have good stability even during the road wet surface, wet road surface. Okay, now we will see the inflation pressure. It is very important. Here an example is given: inside front tire pressure, outside front tire pressure. The inflation pressure should be according to the manufacturer's catalog. Okay, if there is a excessive inflation is there, then more heat is generated on the, and there more heat is generated and there is a damage to the tire. The tread edge wear is more. Even at a 60 kilometer hour low speed, the it is improper handling is noticeable. Okay, this is in under inflation results. If it is over inflation results, then there is a reduction of flexuring and heat generation. The wear of the center tread is more, harsher ride, and the tire tends to puncture when hitting a pointed object. And under inflated tire will merely flex in each case. Here you will observe that over inflation, the tread will comes in contact here. Okay, here is under inflation, and we need a proper inflation. The pressure on the both wheel must be as per the manufacturer requirement. ओके, इट इज व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर लॉन्ग टर्म